Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is the third lecture on the topic of our O-level arithmetic functions. Okay, and we have to sketch how to sketch sine rule and cosine rule. Although this not frequently come, but chances are there. What is method? You can see I made two diagrams and 90-90 gap I made it. Reason is very, very clear. Reason is same caste rule. Okay, caste rule. According to caste rules, so 0 to 90, 90 to 190, 180, plus 90, 270, and plus 90, it gives you 360 degree. And you know, here all positive, here only sine positive, here all positive, here you know sine positive, here tan positive, and here cos positive. You see, and 90-90 gap, that is the reason I showed 90. And you'll see now, inshallah, because here all positive means here sine positive. Actually, let me make diagram for sine. So sine is here positive, here negative, here. So here positive, here negative. And that is why you see now when I will make it, you will happen. But one thing interestingly, I always explain my students, horizontally sine zero. Horizontally mean on x-axis sine zero. So this cross I made for sine. So I give assurance sine 0 is 0, it comes here. Sine 180 again is 0. Sine 360 I give assurance and you can check also 0. What up and down? So up sine 90 is 1. And what is sine 270? So sine 270 is minus 1. Repeat my words. So that is why as a teacher I know these values. Okay? And when I make it, I can make very easily. But in your function calculator, we have a function, the function of table. Okay? Use the function of table. And how to type it? He says start from where? So start the, first of all, you type the function. You know, he will ask f of x equal to what? You say f x equal to sin x. You press the button, he asks start from where? So he says, you say start from zero, this zero. He say ends where? So ends at 360. A step how much? Step means along x-axis how much you want gaps. So actually ideal gap is 30 or as smaller gap you can take. But in this question I will take step 90 degree. So not for sine even for cos. And you can check later on. So if I type sine 0 is 0. At 90 it gives you 100% 1. Add 1 every type sine 0 is 0. Sine 1 a 90 is confirmed 1. Sine, because see here, sine 0 0, sine 90 1, sine 180 0. It means again 0. Sine 270 is minus 1 is how much up? Same down. So add 270, I get minus 1. And 360 again 0. So now let's make a diagram. So you know sine graph is first it goes up, gradually increase and reach here. And symmetrical, same it will go decrease and become this. Then it will go same way in negative and same way. So this is sine graph we get always. Some boys try to join directly. No, wrong. Okay, it is a slowly increase like that. Okay, or first quickly increase, then decrease and parallel to x-axis. Okay, anyway. So what about our cos? So here 0, here 1, and here we have minus 1. Same here, fx equal to what? Cos x. And you have a function calculated in table function. What function name in table? Table function, you have it. When you press it, it will ask you. It will ask you that you start from, write a function. You write function, it will ask start from where? So start from 0. He asks you ends where? And 360 degree. They say how much step? So step is 90 gap. And see here, at 0 and when, okay. Let's talk about the cos. This cross is a, especially for cos. So check please. Okay, you just understand what is, I said horizontally, sine 0. And cos totally reverse. Like everything opposite. Like as a teacher, you know how I memorize sine x 0. If I know sine is 0, what is up and down? 1 and minus 1. And what about cos? Total opposite. For example, sine 0, sine 0, sine 0. What about cos? cos 0 is 1, cos 180 is minus 1, cos 360 is 1. Repeat again. Here sine 0, you see, 0, 0, 0. And cos?
1.
Right, 1, left, minus 1. And what about up and down, sine 1 and minus 1? Here? 0. So cos 90 is 0. And cos 270 is 0. So both are zeros. So let's start. So when I start, I know 0 is 1, so start from here. Okay, 90 is, at 90 0, it's leave here. At 180, it reach on a minus 1. So 180 and minus 1 here. At 270 is 0, again it come back. And 360 is 1, so 1 is here and 360. They meet here. So let's start. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. But if you are not confident and this 90 is confusing you, you take a step of 30. What happened? Then you put smaller value along x-axis and less chance of mistake. And you will get no need to type each value one by one. You do just three steps, you get a whole table and sketch it. I hope so clear. And you've seen that, you have seen that, this is a sine graph. Always start from zero, cos graph, always start from top, or sometimes start from bottom even, but not start from middle, and that's it.